Please be seated. Welcome to this graduation ceremony. I'm Stephen Marston, Vice Chancellor of the University, and I'm delighted to welcome all of you here this afternoon. We welcome back particularly our students from the 2020 cohort who are graduating today. We're also very pleased to see so many families, friends, carers, and supporters who have come to enjoy this special occasion. We meet, of course, still in the long shadow of the coronavirus pandemic. For 20 months, the pandemic has caused massive disruption, anxiety, and loss, both across the country and indeed around the world. Many people, including some of our students and your families and our staff, lost loved ones or fell ill themselves. And pretty much everybody had their normal ways of life, working, traveling, shopping, socializing, turned upside down. I personally will remember for a long time the 23rd of March 2020, when the university was required pretty much overnight to put all of our teaching, learning, and assessment online, and the whole community, students and staff, had to switch to working from home. In those difficult circumstances, students and staff showed amazing creativity and ingenuity in adapting to new ways of working, new ways of using technology to sustain teaching and learning. We were able to ensure that every student could still take their assessments and exams at the end of each module, which is why today we can come together to applaud in these ceremonies the academic qualifications that you, as our students, worked so hard to achieve. That's a wonderful thing to be able to celebrate. At the same time, we know that your experience of being at university as students in 2020 was not what you were expecting, and it's not what the university would have wanted to provide for you. Although core teaching and learning did continue, in normal times, being at university offers students a wide range of other opportunities to enjoy new experiences, meet new people, and discover new places. And for much of the past 20 months, lockdown has made that so much more difficult. One effect of the pandemic was that last year, we had to cancel our graduation ceremonies altogether. And I would like to apologize to all of you that we were not able to hold our graduations last year at the usual time. This year we're holding a double graduation ceremony for last year's graduating students as well as this year's graduating students. So although it is a year later than you or we would have wanted, I hope that today we will still be able to celebrate your achievements in suitable style. It's all the more heartfelt because we know that you have had to wait so long to get proper recognition of your successes and to be able to meet up again with friends, fellow students, and staff. Because if anybody has deserved a celebration, you certainly have. It's wonderful to see you all here today and be able to celebrate your achievements with you. We're celebrating the fact that you achieved your qualifications in exceptionally difficult and disrupted circumstances. Your achievement is really special. You showed courage and resilience, hard work and determination to keep going throughout the pandemic. At the same time, we're celebrating the amazing commitment and professionalism of the university's staff, who did their very best to continue teaching and providing excellent support for their students, often working from their kitchens, their living rooms, their spare bedrooms, maybe while homeschooling or looking after vulnerable family as well. They work miracles to keep courses running, adapting at ultra-high speed to new technology and supporting students to keep going. And we're also celebrating the love and the care of parents, families, friends and carers who supported students in the dark times and helped them to stick with their studies, take their exams and assessments, and carry on to the successful achievement we're applauding today. The success of our graduates is your success as well, so thank you all for the part that you have played. This year, our arrangements for the ceremony must still be mindful of the continuing risks of spreading the virus. This means we're not going to be shaking hands. So instead, what we're going to do is exchange bows. Small bow, like that. When you come up on stage, up the steps there, please walk forward to a grey line you will see on the platform. The Pro-Chancellor will give you a small bow. If you would like to, please give a small bow in return, and then you can walk back down the steps down that way. Please don't worry too much about your hats. So far in these ceremonies, only one hat has entirely fallen off and hit the floor. But I have to say that was because the graduate in question was dancing across the platform. So the lesson here is probably best to avoid dancing if you want to keep your hat on. We're asking everybody in the audience to please applaud as each graduate takes the stage. No one needs to be on mute in terms of clapping, please, at this event. Do please keep wearing your face coverings if you would like to, and please do wear face coverings when leaving the hall at the end of the ceremony and in the circulation spaces where there are lots of people. So now, without further ado, let us proceed with the ceremony, and I call upon the university's Pro-Chancellor, the Bishop of Gloucester, Bishop Rachel Treweek, to make her address. Thank you and welcome.
Vice-Chancellor, distinguished and honoured guests, ladies and gentlemen. As Pro-Chancellor and Bishop of Gloucester, it is a real privilege and a delight to be here to acknowledge and celebrate the achievements of these graduates from the University of Gloucestershire. And the most important thing I want to do is to congratulate you, the graduates. To achieve your award, as we've heard, has not been straightforward, as you have lived the uncertainties and ever-changing landscape of a viral pandemic. You have displayed immense commitment to learning, whilst also being deprived of so much relating over these past months. I know that students at this university usually make very good use of their time to develop more than just academic credentials. Yet I also know that for you, the graduates, a viral pandemic has stopped you from being able to explore more of who you are fully through activities such as sport or through involvement in students' union clubs and societies, or through placements and volunteering in the wider community. You have not been able to undertake so much of university life that you had hoped for. And yet, here you are graduating, shaped by your experiences and continuing to fulfill your potential. So once again, I say huge congratulations. One of the things I always love about graduation day is watching people taking proud photographs. It's a day when at one level you all look very similar because of the caps and gowns. Yet you also choose to express your uniqueness, and we will see that reflected today, no doubt, in the great array of footwear which we will see on the stage. And today, I want to encourage you to go on recognizing your unique value. It's so easy for people to compare themselves with others, to wonder if you are really good enough, to lack confidence deep down within. And of course, the truth is that we are all flawed and a bit broken, but we also each have full potential, and there is no one else in the world the same as you. You have a unique part to play in this world, so please don't ever see yourself as insignificant. As graduates, you are among the most talented of our society, and as you go on making choices about how you use who you are, how you use your skills and gifts and learning, you have immense potential to go on reimagining and shaping both the present and the future. Over this past 18 months or so, a number of issues have received a lot of attention and protest. For example, Black Lives Matter, violence against women and girls, issues around the climate. And I don't think it's any coincidence that feeling has been strong throughout this pandemic, because consciously or subconsciously, it has provoked us to think about the sort of world we want to live in and how we shape the future. And yes, that will be about you as unique individuals, but only ever in relationship. And over this past 18 months or so, we've been painfully reminded that as human beings, we are creatures of relationship and interdependence. Perhaps we've learned even more about our relationship with the planet as well. One of the phrases I've refused to use since the start of the pandemic is that of social distancing. Yes, we have needed and do need to keep physical distance as we care for one another. But socially, we actually need to go on learning more of how we go towards one another, particularly towards people who are different from ourselves and how we live in relationship. And if your learning and knowledge and expertise is to be life-giving, then it must be put to work not only for your private benefit, but also for the benefit of society at large. You are going to have so many opportunities to contribute to human flourishing in so many ways and places. And for many of you, that will be in schools and places of education, but also in numerous other places too. Daily, you will have opportunities to contribute to the flourishing of people of all ages and backgrounds, and indeed the flourishing of the earth. In your daily encounters with people, how you choose to use your time, money, and skills, you can and will influence the shape of the world and country and communities we want to live in. I commented on that fabulous range of shoes we will see. If you can dare to recognize not only your own unique value, but also the value of those around you, you will develop that great gift of being able to stand in the shoes of other people, many of whom will have different perspectives, beliefs, and experiences from your own. If you can work hard at this, then you have enormous potential to work for the common good in our world. So I want to encourage you today to, yes, celebrate your own shoes, but also to stand in the unique shoes of others, perhaps not literally. In the years ahead, the university looks forward to finding out what you've gone on to do, even in this past year. So when you are contacted through the graduate outcome survey, please do tell us what you are up to. And don't forget that the Your Future Plans team continue to be available to support you even once you've graduated. And of course, if you go on to make lots of money, the university will particularly celebrate you if you don't forget them. But let me draw to a close. Today is your day to remember, to celebrate, and to cherish. No doubt you are going to find all sorts of ways to celebrate today, and there will be many good memories. And once again, I want to say congratulations as we celebrate your achievement and your future promise. Thank you for the hope you are offering each and every one of us as you live the present and shape the future. Congratulations.
Good afternoon. I am Dr. Matthew Andrews, the University Secretary and Registrar, and it is my pleasure to add my warmest welcome and sincerest congratulations to those graduating here today. We will shortly proceed to the conferment of awards on graduands, which will be presented by Dr. Graham Parton, Head of the School of Education and Humanities. The awards will be conferred by the Pro-Chancellor of the University, Bishop Rachel Treweek. Before the awards are conferred, however, we invite you to enjoy a short video as a reminder of your time with us.
Pro-Chancellor, I present to you candidates from the School of Education, and I commend to you those recorded as in absentia. For the award of Bachelor of Arts, Early Childhood Studies, Lucy Rebecca Admonds. Kaylee Sarah Allardyce. Joel Allaby. Poppy Louise Bettles. Abby Savannah Braddock. Elliot Brownsey. Eleanor Ann Burrows. Alaska Rosa Cormack. Amy Cranfield. Alice Victoria Fiddler. Tegan Jessica Goodedge. Jade Gooding. Amy Elizabeth Dawn Holt. Siobhan Johns. Annalise Jones. Natasha Lee Jones. Chloe Lee. Kate Arachar Mason. Lydia Morby. Ellie Louise Morrissey. Catherine Norris. Lucy Marie Pottinger. Catherine Lucy Jane Powell. Sophie Elizabeth Reed. Annabelle Richardson. Hannah Richardson. Alice Emily Simpson. Isabel Jane Louise Taylor. Emily Elizabeth Alice Trudgeon. Millie White. For the award of Bachelor of Arts Education, Sarah Angle. Liam Bradley Atkins. Isabel Amy Biggs. Hannah Butler. Jenna Cooper. Selena Ann Edmonds. Bethany Kemp. Megan Lewis. Emma Millington. Chloe Murray. Asley Omer. Mary O'Shea. Nicole Percival. Deanna Janice Eileen Prendergast. Emily White. Toby Woodward May. For the award of Bachelor of Arts Education Studies, Susie Pope. For the award of Bachelor of Education, Primary Education, Foundation Stage and Key Stage 1, Rachel Ann Ballinger. Lydia Louise Coopy. Ella Elizabeth Sydney Danter. Imogen Nancy Farr. James Gamble. Lucy Bronwyn Harris. Amy Catherine Hiles. Charlotte Hilson. Jack Robert Holman. Shannon Phoebe Marley Ludwell. Lucy Lai. Ryan O'Toole. Madeline May Smith. Abigail Walker. Paige Walters. Alexandra Waters. Bianca Zolkova. For the award of Bachelor of Education, Primary Education, Key Stage 1 and Key Stage 2, Amber Josephine Bailey. Emily Ball. Eleanor Barnett. Deborah Booth. Rebecca Louise Brady. Sarah Brooks. Rhys Cliff. Jessica Louise Cook. Francesca Thurza Diamato. Oliver Day. Eleanor DeCarles. Kaylee Dixon. Asha Didcot. Ashley Doyle. Kelsey Dyke. Amy Fitzgibbon. Leanne Chelsea Rebecca Greenwood. Jessica Amy Grinter. Alice Hastings. Georgia Hinton. Holly May Hipkiss. Awine David Heyer. Emma Rhiannon Hope. Phoebe Houghton. Caitlin Fay Hughes. Katie Hunt. Hannah Louise Jackman. Bonnie McKenzie. Asher Morgan. Charlotte Newton. Emma Nichols. Kevin Norton. James Edward Orchard. Rebecca O'Sullivan. Jasmine Joanne Paul. William Powell. Emma Jane Randall. Jessica Roberts. Molly Rudge. Anuska Smith. Lauren Rose Spencer. Laurel Jean Thomas. Katie Louise Towle. Joel Harry Andrew Williams. Charlotte Lucy Isabel Woodman. For the award of Bachelor of Education, Primary Education, Maths, Key Stage 1 and Key Stage 2, Hannah Elizabeth Baldry. Emma Louise Borg. Daniel Lee Brooks. Timothy James Couts. Victoria Drongle. Oliver Greensveig. Zhao Ru Grumble. Matilda Bernadette Myella Hampton. William Henry Lewis. Megan Emily Ray. Sophie Reed. Robin Ashley Roberts. Eve Frances Selden. Kira Mary Tumelty. Benjamin Williams. For the award of Bachelor of Arts, School Business Management, Serco Education, Rosette Doxon. Curtis George. Deborah Stevens. Claire Wheeler. For the award of Postgraduate Certificate Early Years, Layla Dovey. Megan Mary Christine Harper. Abigail Rose Lewis. Charlotte Mary Elizabeth Roberts. Georgina Sally Diana Smith. Hannah Elizabeth Taylor. For the award of Master of Education Early Years, Lindsay Morley. For the award of Master of Arts Education, Trifosa Otiana Bennett. Eleanor Amy Jones. Jodie Louise Stanley. For the award of Master of Arts Educational Leadership, Connor Gary Valentine Booth. Julie Haynes. Judith Francis Hunt. Fiona McMarine. Daniel Neild. For the award of Master of Education, Inclusive Education Incorporating National Award for Special Educational Needs Coordination, Alice Victoria Hibbard. Julianne Palmer. For the award of Postgraduate Certificate, National Award for Special Educational Needs Coordination, Helen Elizabeth Stratford. For the award of Postgraduate Certificate in Education, Primary Education, Emily Absalom. Hannah Beckett. Danielle Bird. Natalie Mary Bradshaw. Adam James Brown. Nathan David Clark. Lauren Clutterbuck. Zoe Harriet Cotton. Jessie Cross. Maria Curtis Fisher. Alice May Davies. Victoria Discombe. Chloe Louise Fitzsimmons. Coral Jade Flynn. Phoebe Rose Gore. Joanna Louise Grieve. Jasmine Charlotte Hall. Bethany Howell. Ryan John Lewis. Helena Marsh. Isabella Martin. Megan Louisa Painter. Paige Ridgers. Bethany Rimmer. Anna Robson. Harriet Elizabeth Smith. Lucy Rebecca Thurlow. Emma Trehan. Hayley Francesca Welch. Catherine Natasha White. Neve Winters. For the award of Professional Graduate Certificate in Education, Primary Education, Nadia Ahmed. Emily Clark. Amy Kate Healy. Kate Morris. Lauren Sophie Porter. Alice Elizabeth Treadgett. Katie Watt. Kate Maria Webster. Andrew Luke Wood. For the award of Master of Education, Professional Studies in Education, Hayley Passaway. For the award of Postgraduate Certificate in Education, Secondary Education, Holly Butcher. Maureen Clutterbuck. Jamie Cook. Callum Dixie. Shantae Shavel Drummond. Eleanor Giles. Cressy Harrington. Katrina Harris. Megan Hatton. Kate Heyman. Amber Rose Parslow. Kellyanne Rabbit. Eleanor Jennifer Towler. Isabel Wilkinson. For the award of Professional Graduate Certificate in Education, Secondary Education, Darren Michael Laban. For the award of postgraduate certificate, mainly by research, research methods, Lusabulu M. Ind. Shalu Rai. I now present to you candidates upon whom the degree of Doctor of Philosophy is to be conferred. Alice Parkin. Michelle Louise Ward. Pro-Chancellor, that concludes my presentation for awards.
I am now pleased to introduce performing arts student Sophie Lockwood, who will sing Goodbye from Catch Me If You Can. She will be supported by David Last, academic subject leader in performing arts and production. Many thanks to Sophie and David. We now continue with the presentation of special prizes, which will be introduced by Dr. Graham Parton.
The Marjorie Payne Prize is awarded for outstanding academic achievement in early years teacher education. I invite the Vice-Chancellor to present the prize to this year's winner, Megan Harper. The Moores Legacy Prize is awarded for an outstanding B.Ed. Honours primary dissertation. This year we have three prize winners, and I invite the Vice-Chancellor to present the award to Robin Roberts, Abigail Walker and Sophie Reed. The Old Students Association Prize is awarded in memory of former student and loyal friend to the university, Mike Compson, who passed away in 2020. Megan began his studies at our predecessor institution, St. Paul's College, in 1964, and spent the rest of his life supporting the university. In all those years, he never missed a meeting of the Old Students Association, who created the prize we are presenting today. We give thanks for Mike for his enthusiasm and friendship, and all of our former students for the contribution they have made to the fabric of our university. The Old Student Association Prize is awarded to the graduate who displayed outstanding classroom teaching, and I invite the Vice-Chancellor to present the prize to this year's winner, Cressy Harrington. Pro-Chancellor, that concludes my presentation of special prizes.
The University has decided to confer honorary titles on a small number of distinguished individuals who merit special recognition for outstanding achievement and distinction internationally, nationally, and at a local level. I now call upon Dr. Graham Parton to present the citation in honour of Eve Jardine Young.
Pro-Chancellor, distinguished guests, graduates, ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to present to you Eve Jardine Young, upon whom the university is to confer an honorary fellowship. Eve has been principal of Cheltenham Ladies College since 2011. She spent her early years living in Malawi, Central Africa, and attended St. Andrews International High School until she was 16. She then accepted a scholarship to the Cheltenham Ladies College for sixth form. After leaving the school, she studied engineering science at the University of Cambridge. Having worked in industry for a little while, she then entered the teaching profession, beginning at Radley College in Oxford, later moving to Epsom College in Surrey, where she taught economics. In 2005, she moved to Blundell's School in Devon, where she was director of studies for 6 years. She then took up her appointment at the Ladies' College. Founded in 1853 to provide a sound academic institution for girls, the independent boarding and day school provides education for girls aged between 11 and 18. The school is consistently ranked as one of the best girls' schools in the country. And last year, the Cheltenham Ladies' College was named Southwest Independent School of the Decade by the Times and the Sunday Times. Eve has played a significant role in establishing the newly formed Cheltenham Educational Partnership, which brings together local secondary schools with the University of Gloucestershire. It is an equal partnership of secondary schools from both the maintained and independent sectors. From both the values of this partnership are collaboration and cooperation, and the driving ambition of the partnership is to expand the horizons of young people in Cheltenham and to help them realise their full potential. Today we are recognising Eve's contribution to education in Gloucestershire. Pro-Chancellor, I now call upon you to confer the award of Honorary Fellow upon Eve Jardine Young.
What a wonderful, wonderful afternoon. Thank you so much for the enormous privilege, not only of this moment of recognition, but also to be here and to see these incredible young people who have decided, out of many other possible things they could have done at this stage in their lives, to begin perhaps a journey into teaching, into education. It's absolutely wonderful that you have made that decision, and I hope it brings you many, many years of fulfilment ahead. Life expectancy at the moment is increasing at the rate of half an hour a day, and we're already in the third of the decades of the 21st century, so no one in our school, in fact no one in schools, has ever lived as a pupil, has ever lived in the 20th century. So for folks who've been in education for the 30 years that I have or longer, times have changed a little. But the motto of our town of Cheltenham translates into health and education. How incredibly prescient that we have had this time now over the COVID pandemic challenges, which of course are ongoing, where those two enormous themes and those two profoundly important themes for humanity have combined. How people have come to recognize and appreciate afresh that actually teaching isn't just something that anybody can do. If done really well, it is truly transformational for people. Not only the student, but actually for us as teachers. I wonder if any of us still have those moments in our memories where the light bulb comes on, you've explained something, you've helped somebody to understand something, and there's a quite unique feeling of inspiration that comes back to you when you see your students making progress, when the light bulb comes on, one might say. It's a rewarding, it's a fulfilling, it's often challenging, sometimes frustrating way of spending your days, but I've never regretted a single day, and I hope that you have lives ahead of you that bring you equivalent richness. There's a French writer of children's stories who said the following: if you wish to build a ship, do not organize the wood, arrange the men, and give the orders. Instead, teach them how to yearn for the vast and endless sea. I think in the last couple of years, we've all recognized that established practice, established knowledge, and ways and methods of doing things just have not been enough to fully meet all of the challenges of our time. And human innovation, human agility, nimbleness, innovation, creativity, and the ability to work together have emerged as those enduring human qualities that I'm sure will carry us through all of the challenges in the years that still lie ahead of us. I believe that you and all of our students in our schools are amongst the best educated generations who have probably ever lived. I think you're certainly the most informed students who have ever lived. At the touch of a button, at the click of our fingers, is an enormous and unprecedentedly vast quantity of information. And perhaps our challenge now is to learn better and better ways of navigating through what can sometimes feel like a white noise of incoming fire. I can think of no better group of people who are equipped so well, having been inspired and supported through your years and your research and your period of training, to be equipped to navigate that pathway and help young children through that too. Steve Jobs, who I'm sure needs no introduction as the former founder of Apple, but his successor, Tim Cook, spoke to the graduating class of MIT a few years ago, and he said, "You will be making a choice. Will you put your humanity at the center of your technology? Or I wonder whether you will put your technology at the center of your humanity. How you choose as a generation will take us to a different place." And I think over the last few months, as education and lectures and research and assignments have all required us to re-examine afresh the relationship between our technology that can be so enabling and so empowering, and our humanity that really I think has emerged as something so deeply, deeply precious, and something that the fellowship of being around each other, our conversations, our encouragement, and our friendship matters greatly, and I think, I hope, those will be things that will carry you through in your years ahead. Thank you so much again for the tremendous honour of your award. I appreciate it so much, and I hope you'll come, hope you'll stay in teaching, everyone who's out there. Enjoy. Enjoy the rest of the day. Thank you.
I now call upon Dr. Parton to present the citation in honour of Mariam Khan.
Pro-Chancellor, distinguished guests, graduates, ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to present to you Mariam Khan, upon whom the university is to confer an honorary doctorate of philosophy. Mariam is a writer and editor, frustrated and angry at the way Muslim women are spoken about by the media, politicians, and white feminists in order to further their own agenda. Mariam noted that Muslim women never had the opportunity to speak for themselves without filter. In effort to fill this void, Mariam compiled and edited the highly acclaimed and tremendously important collection of 17 essays by Muslim women about what it is to be a Muslim woman in the West today, called It's Not About the Burqa, Muslim Women on Faith, Feminism, Sexuality and Race. The book was inspired by a report Mariam read about a leaked conversation that the British Prime Minister, David Cameron, had with one of his officials. In that conversation, he said that the traditional submissiveness of Muslim women was a key problem in the fight against Islamic extremism. Mariam was fed up of hearing about what Muslim women were from people who were neither Muslim nor female. This book was nominated for Foyle's Non-Fiction Book of the Year 2019 and has seen Merriam tour extensively to speak at literature festivals and schools about her book and the importance of hearing the voice of Muslim women firsthand. Today we are recognising Merriam's achievements in providing a platform for Muslim women and giving a voice to the wide-ranging experience of Muslim women living in the West. We also recognise the importance of her work within higher education to make the curriculum and course reading lists fully inclusive and accessible to all students, which we value in our own efforts to become a truly inclusive community for all our students and staff. Pro-Chancellor, I now call upon you to confer the award of Honorary Doctor of Philosophy upon Merriam Khan.
Thank you so much for this incredible honour. I do not have anything prepared, so I'm going to wing it, but just stay with me. I know it's been a long, long afternoon. I've been a student in education for the longest time. I feel like I'm always learning, and one of the things that has empowered me as a Muslim woman is constantly educating myself, constantly asking why, questioning those who feel like they have a voice that's more educated than mine. And I feel like that's something that isn't afforded to so many women of color and so many Muslim women, and that isn't for lack of them not having the intelligence to voice their opinions. So my work and the work that I've done so far and the work that has been recognized today and is basically about platforming those voices. And I'm so grateful to be a part of this cohort of students who will hopefully stay in teaching and educate and empower the next generation and future generations and empower their voices and their beliefs and their opinions in the classroom and outside of it. And in the gaps where the education system does miss out, because as much as I do love the education system, it does miss out empowering some of us. I hope that you can go that extra mile and that I can ask that of you to go that extra mile to empower those of your students who are not seen by the education system too. So I want to say thank you so much for this honor, and I will continue to do my work and continue to create spaces, and I hope the cohort that's graduating today will take heed to my words and do the same in the classrooms as well. Thank you.
I now invite Luke Brown, representing the University of Gloucestershire Students' Union, to add his own words of congratulation.
Pro-Chancellor, Vice-Chancellor, distinguished guests, graduates of 2020, and families and friends. As a fellow graduate, may I congratulate you on all of your success and achievements in what has been a really challenging time. Although our final year was cut short and didn't end in the way that we wanted it, the strength you have all shown to carry on and to make it here today, and the support that you gave one another, is something to be proud of. May your time at the University of Gloucestershire remain a happy memory, and may you continue to support the university and be proud to have studied here. We are now all members of this alumni, and as we continue our journey through life and onto our next steps, we should cherish our memories of our time here and remember the university, as well as treasure the friends we have made. We are all here together as we say goodbye to our university. I'm sure you will all agree with me what a special day this has been, and that being here would not have been made possible without a great deal of support from your families and your friends, your lecturers, your peers, and the support of the university. Today, you have been celebrated and congratulated. So in a moment, I would like to invite you, the graduates of 2020, to stand and show your appreciation by way of applause to those who have supported you. I wish you the very best of luck for the future. You did it. Congratulations. You should be very proud. Thank you.
Thank you, and thank you, Luke. This brings our graduation ceremony to an end. Thank you all so much for coming. To our new graduates, thank you particularly. It has been a real privilege to have you as members of our university community, seeing you grow in achievement and confidence. And it has been a great pleasure to be able to celebrate with you today the award of your qualifications. To parents, families, and partners, I hope you too will feel proud of the important part you have played in supporting and encouraging our new graduates to achieve success. We wish you all the very best for the future, and I now declare this ceremony closed. Thank you.